My name is Rajib Saha. I'm an assistant professor from the Department of Chemical and Biomolecular Engineering here at University of Nebraska, Lincoln.
I'm Dr. Mark Wilkins. I'm a professor in biological systems engineering and in food science and technology. And then I also am the director of the Industrial Agricultural Products Center. Our project is to seek to produce succinic acid, which is not only a food ingredient, but is also can be used in plastics manufacturing and in other uses as well. We're trying to make that from corn fiber. So, you know, a corn kernel mostly consists of starch, also has some protein and oil, but it also has fiber. And right now the fiber is essentially fed to cattle, and that's it's pretty much its only use. So what we're trying to do is add value to that fiber by producing a really valuable product from it.
We are interested in converting low-value products like corn stover into high-value products using microorganisms, taking advantage of their biochemical capabilities. One example is the organism Actinobacillus succinogens, which is isolated from the rumen of cattle. And we like that organism because it can use a variety of different sugars found in corn fiber, and we can, it will then convert that low value product into a high value product, which is called succinate. And succinate can be used for all kinds of things, including bioplastics and a variety of chemicals can be made from succinate. And so Actinobacillus succinogens naturally produces a lot of succinate. In the lab, as it makes all that succinate, which is an acid, succinic acid, the pH of the media drops a lot to where the organism can no longer live. And so what we are working on in this lab is then giving the organism the ability to survive in that low pH as it's making lots of succinate for us by engineering it to maintain its internal pH at a close to 7, while its external pH can be down around 4. And this is also very useful for downstream processing.
We are interested to make processes more efficient. In the future, we don't want to limit ourselves to like a 3-liter, 10-liter reactor. Rather, we would be happy to tie this project up with an existing facility, a bioethanol facility, so that we can, you know, produce succinic acid in higher quantity. Down the line, that's what I envision this project.